not under radar. Nobody was talking about it. India did not have its own law. The Indian law was enacted only in 1986. I started in 1980-81. There was no program run by any United Nations agency. The ILO started its program in early mid-90s. So was the time when UNICEF started program against child labor and for child rights, because the United Nations has adopted the UN Convention on the Rights of the Child only in 1989, almost 10 years after when I started. But it worked. 20 years ago, the number of child laborers in the world was 260 million. 26 crore bacche baal mazdoori karte the 20 saal pehle. And that has decreased to 168 million, as I said. 17 crore se bhi kam ho gaye hain 20 saal ke andar. 26 crore se 17 crore ho gaye. Is it not remarkable? The evil, the crime which has been growing, the graph was going up, it has gone down. It was possible because of the power of young people, power of civil society, which has been supported by the good governments, politicians, academics, and all kind of people, industries also. That worked. 2 decades ago, the number of out-of-school children, according to United Nations statistics, was 130 million, 13 crore. That number has been decreased to 59 million, 6 crore. 13 crore se ghatke 6 crore aa gaya. Sudhar hua ki nahi hua? Change is possible. We have to look at it. Now, bigger challenges are still ahead. The universities like yours, Open University, and all universities actually, they should think of education, the colleges, the schools, educational institutions should think of an education which is quality education, the education which is inclusive education, the education with equity. So equitable, quality and inclusive education is underlying. We live in a world where several problems are cropping up. May it be global warming, may it be global terrorism, may it be other problems, poverty, unemployment. What we have seen or what we are witnessing in case of Greece, for instance, because of indebtedness and so on. These things crop up again and again. Countries are becoming bankrupts. Individuals are becoming bankrupts. Banks are becoming bankrupts time to time. All these things are happening. So when we talk of education, especially in the colleges and universities, we have to ensure that education must bring employability. Education cannot ensure employment, but education can ensure employability. Education can also ascertain entrepreneurship. But along with entrepreneurship and employability, we have to ascertain excellence in education. We live in a globalized world. We live in a competitive world. And in this competitive, where we are living in the age of knowledge economy, that should be the knowledge at par. The most advanced, the most sophisticated, the most scientific knowledge will matter. Just chota bada likhna, A, B, C, D likhna, padhna, basic literacy, poor quality education, the conventional thought about education would not work. The universities have to be more innovative. The young people should bring their input to the universities. I would request this university also and vice chancellors and the faculties and the board members to listen to the young people's voices, that what they wanted to see in education in the coming 5 years or 10 years. More innovations are needed in education systems. Traditional way will not work because we are competing with the rest of the world. Sometimes when the President of India, none other than the President of India, in one of the speeches says that India does not have one single university which can compete with the top 100 universities. We are not in one of those 100 universities. 200. Hum 200 university mein se ek bhi university nahi rakhte. Hum Nalanda, Takshashila wale desh hain. Hum Jagat Guru wale desh hain. Lekin if we keep on doing this rhetoric all the time instead of doing something really concrete on the ground to make our education system at par with the rest of the world, with the par excellence, it is not easy. Those days are gone when education was considered as employment source only. Now education is empowerment. Education is the key to social justice, gender justice, equality in the society. Education is the fundamental right, which is the key to rest of the human rights and constitutional rights in any society, in any country. We have to change the perception towards education. It is not only for employment and livelihood, it is beyond that. Our country is talking about economic growth for quite some time. We are open to market economy and so on for many years. And now there is a push. It's great. But I will tell you, I will refer you some of those recent studies. World Bank has carried out a study in 50 countries. And the result was, they have suggested that if a country is able to impart basic education, primary education for all its children, then only through education, primary education, it can enhance its GDP by 0.37%, almost 4% per year, just primary education. But if this education is tertiary and secondary education, then this GDP growth rate will be 1% per year or more, additional. If we have, say, 6-7% GDP growth rate, it can become 1% more if we are able to impart education for our children. In the lives of individuals, there is another study which has been carried out by World Bank and UNESCO and other UN agencies recently, which suggests that investment on education by $1. If you invest $1 on education, the return would be $15 over the next 20 years. That is possible. That is the reality of the world. So we have to invest now more on education so that we can get better return. But see, child labor, trafficking of children are among the worst obstacles in achieving education goals. And that's why we cannot simply leave it to the governments that government is not doing this, government is not doing this, central government is wrong here, state government is wrong there, and ideological issues, political issues, all these things. They are there everywhere in the world. But as young people, as students, as concerned citizens, what role we are playing if we see that a child is being beaten up on the street? If a girl is being abused by some manchale log? What we do? If we see that a trafficker is taking girls from Kokrajhar, from Lakhimpur, from bringing from Arunachal Pradesh and passing through Guwahati, do we raise our voice? Do we call our police? We simply think that the police is corrupt. Maybe some people are corrupt. But there are good people in the police also. Why don't we call them? And call again. It is not easy sometimes, but we should try at least. Many of them, most of them don't try out, and we keep on blaming the system. Very easy to blame the system. But we are the part of that system, and we cannot simply put the buck on others' back. Friends, I will tell my young people, as I said before, no other segment of life, no other demographic segment of society can match with your power and also with your idealism. I know that you are hungry to do something better for the society. It is the failure of the state. It is the failure of the old people. It is the failure of all of us, including myself, that we are not able to give dreams and aspirations and better meaning of life. We are not able to inculcate the values of mutual responsibility and citizenship among our young people. And that's why the young people are destructed. But you should take the rein in your hands. आप अपने हाथ में ताकत लीजिए. जब स्वामी विवेकानंद खड़े होते हैं दुनिया की सबसे बड़ी धर्म संसद में और जवानों को ललकारते हैं, उत्तिष्ठ जागृत प्राप्य वरान्य बोधक, पूरी दुनिया सुनती है. नौजवान सन्यासी भारत का खड़ा होता है. दोस्तों, आज से शुरू करो. ड्रीम, ड्रीम बिग. हु स्टॉप्स यू टू ड्रीम? If you are going to dream, dream big. Those who dream big for themselves only, they are not the change makers. They are very selfish. They are very selfish. Dream for yourself big, but dream for your nation. Dream for Assam. Dream for the whole world. When I call any of the young people and ask them, what is your dream in 10 years? One can come and say that I wanted to become a professor. But when I ask, I have been to some colleges and schools here in Assam also, and I ask those young people that what you dream for your state, Assam ke liye aapka 10 saal baad ka kya sapna hai? Sir, we have never thought about it. The answer is, what is the dream for your nation? Oh, ye to aur mushkil hai. And what is the dream for the world? World ke baare mein pata nahi. They have no idea about it. So dream for yourself and dream for others. Dream for your nation, dream for the whole humanity. That is first D. The second D, discover. Discover the power within you. The Indian philosophy, which I strongly believe in. I tell you that I am not driven by any political ideology. I am not driven by any career orientation, which I gave up when I was an engineer many, many years ago. Career, ek chhod ke isse acha kya hoga? Un dino koi soch bhi nahi sakta. Main ek bahut ameer parivar se nahi aata. Sadharan parivar se. बहुत गरीब भी नहीं थे हम लोग. माई फादर वॉज ए सिंपली पुलिस कॉन्स्टेबल व्हेन आई वॉज बॉर्न. माई मदर वॉज इलिटरेट हाउस वाइफ, बट शी वॉज डिटरमिंड दैट ऑल हर चिल्ड्रन मस्ट गो टू स्कूल, इंक्लूडिंग हर डॉटर. सबको स्कूल भेजा हो, इंक्लूडिंग माई सेल्फ. ऑल माई ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स, सम ऑफ देम आर PhDs, सम ऑफ देम प्रोफेसर्स. My sister retired as the principal from a college recently, elder sister. I was the youngest. So everybody loved me. I was the most adorable child in the family and more naughty as well. So when I gave up my career 35 years ago, my state, Madhya Pradesh, which was combined Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh, did not have too many engineering colleges and engineers. Only 6 or 7 colleges Between 300 to 350 engineers passed out every year. I was one of them. So my mother cried for many days, many weeks. She was very concerned about my livelihood, but also the danger I was inviting, challenging the mafias and slave masters and traffickers. Very worried. But I discovered the potential in me. I discovered the possibilities and opportunities in our surroundings, in my country. The biggest strength of my country is we are the largest democracy in the world. I discovered that India may be the land of 100 problems, but India is the mother of 1 billion solutions that I discovered when I gave up my career as an electric engineer. Discover the strength of this motherland. Discover the inner strength inside you. Use it to embrace all the left out children in the world, to begin with in your neighborhood, in your state, in your country. Discover. So dream is first D, discover is second D. And the third D, if you dream big for yourself and even for your nation, if you discover power inside you and opportunity outside and sit quiet, then better to become a philosopher or a priest or I don't know what. Then the third most important is do. Do. Act. Act now. Act here. Today is the time to act. This is the place to act. I am the one who has to act. We cannot leave it on others. If I believe in something, I will act. That is the power, my young friends. So dream, discover, and बहुत धीरे धीरे रहोगे तो असम कैसे बनेगा? I say that Northeast is the mirror of India. If the young people of Northeast are not respected in the entire country with dignity and respect, then we cannot respect India. Northeast is the mirror. You are the mirrors of the country. So speak loudly. Look in the world. When some of us gave a call to the young people to raise the voice against illiteracy, call for education, what we call the World at School campaign, more than 7 million children, young people like you, have responded. 7 million young people stood up now and say that